As of November 16th of 2025, there are currently 40 volcanoes that are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one less than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is the Democratic Republic of the Congo's Nyiragongo volcano, which contains the world's largest active lava lake at the present, measuring 200 meters or 656 feet wide. While the lava lake's size has varied during the last 360 years, it has been measured anywhere from 60 to a whopping 1,000 meters across. This lava lake, which is incredibly low in silica, typically builds over multiple years until being catastrophically released downslope, where its molten rock can flow at speeds of up to 60 miles per hour in dangerous flank eruptions. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In the Democratic Republic of the Congo, a lengthy multi-pronged lava flow from the Nyamuragira volcano continued to expand away from its summit, advancing nearly a full kilometer in the last week. Meanwhile, in Chile, something unexpected occurred at the Llaima volcano. A rare tornado formed and then moved on or just above the snow-covered volcanic landscape. And in what is this week's top story, the Taal volcano in the Philippines produced another large phreatomagmatic eruption after 2 weeks of no eruptive activity. This eruption in question began at 6:51 a.m. local time on November 12th when shallow magma directly contacted the bottom of Taal's central crater lake on Taal Island. This caused a rapid expansion of adjacent lake water to steam, generating tremendous pressure and then a powerful explosion which ejected some fresh bits of lava despite the lack of obvious orange-red fragments in the aforementioned footage. This eruption lasted for 3 minutes, generating pyroclastic surges that were seemingly confined to within its central crater rim, with the aforementioned eruption plume rising to an altitude of 2,800 meters or 9,186 feet. Now, while this explosion was large in the context of the many phreatic and phreatomagmatic eruptions that have frequently occurred since Taal's January 2020 eruption ended, it was small in the context of overall world volcanic eruptions, likely only rating on the 0 to 9 Volcanic Explosivity Index as a 1. This eruption, after all, was smaller than a similar eruption on October 26th. All of this recent eruptive activity since last December was generated by very minor leftover magma at fairly shallow depths beneath the volcano. No new magma is intruding there, meaning that while there is the potential for more similarly sized eruptions to occur in my opinion, there shouldn't be enough magma present to generate any eruptions one or more orders of magnitude larger. The November 12th eruption in question occurred due to a buildup of pressure that seemingly was linked with a continuous volcanic tremor that began at 3:22 a.m. local time on November 7th and continued for multiple days nonstop until the eruption happened. Meanwhile, in South America, an underreported story, at least in the United States news, was the fact that a deadly tornado outbreak struck Brazil on November 7th, leading to nearly 1,000 casualties. These casualties almost solely occurred via the strongest of 10 tornadoes that were generated that day, which was rated as an F4, which caused the highest number of casualties of any South American tornado since 1987. Now, you might be wondering what the Southern Hemisphere severe weather outbreak has to do with geology. Well, this storm system seemingly moved southwestward the following day, leading to hail, thunderstorms, and then, unexpectedly, a tornado on the northern flank of a glacier in snow-covered Llaima volcano. This tornado only lasted for a little less than 5 minutes, causing no damage, but intermittently jumping on and off the ground for a little more than 1,900 meters. While completely unrelated to any true volcanic activity at Llaima, which has not erupted since 2009, it was quite abnormal considering that the air temperature at the time was near freezing where the tornado occurred. And in the Democratic Republic of the Congo, the Nyamuragira shield volcano has since the start of October been producing an ever-growing lava flow. This lava flow, likely involving tephrite composition lava, overflowed the north rim of its caldera on October 16th. Since then, lava has been slowly advancing in multiple lobes by up to 220 meters a day, and in the last week has lengthened nearly a kilometer while also covering another half square kilometer in lava. Thankfully, this occurred in a spot where no one lives, where other young lava flows have also struck in historical times. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on November 15th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel member, Pontoon, for upgrading their membership tier, thus supporting my work.